If you're like me and thought that the picture profiles on Sony cameras had no effect on raw image capture, then you're about to be surprised. Let's get undone.
Gerald Undone. He's crazy.
What's happening, everybody? I'm Gerald Undone, and where am I going and why am I in this handcart? So today I was working on my review for the Sony A6400, and I was comparing some images really closely, and I noticed that they looked different despite everything else being exactly the same. And I finally narrowed it down that it was the picture profile causing this problem. And I feel bad because I've told other people in the past that picture profiles don't really have an impact on raw image capture, because they don't really on almost any other camera, and I guess I just came to assume that. But I figured out exactly what's happening. And it turns out they do have an impact, but only one element, and that's the gamma. So I have a whole bunch of images here to show you to prove this point, but I think this is important because when I tried to search for this thing myself, and I googled, you know, do picture profiles affect raw images, I would say that there's an overwhelming amount of answers that say, no, they don't, no, they don't, no, they don't. But they do. They definitely do. And this is even backed up a little bit by the Sony help guide. So first thing, let me just jump right into Lightroom here. And before we get into it, I'll also show you Capture One. I have the Capture One for Sony, and it's exactly the same. It's also the same on Luminar. Any program is going to do this. So let's jump into Lightroom right here. So I'm going to import directly off the card, and I have a list here of every shot that I took and what I changed on them. Now, first up, right away, if we just look at this collage here, we can see what's happening. And we can also see why I think it's the consensus that picture profiles don't have an impact. But let's break this down first. So the first three were all taken with picture profiles set to off. And when you do this, when it's in photo mode, you can change the creative style. So that's all that this is three different creative styles. Then I switched for the rest of them to picture profile 2, which is the still gamma. And that matches picture profile off, which I'm also going to show you. And it doesn't really matter which picture profile you use, as long as the picture profile is completely reset and the gamma is set to still, then they'll all match, and they'll match picture profile being off when you're in photo mode. I realize that might have been a little bit confusing, but I'm going to explain it as we go. So if you look at these ones here, we can see this one's black and white, we can see this one's got the saturation bumped up, and then there's some differences throughout the other ones. But when we actually import these into Lightroom, that's when it's going to develop the RAWs, because up until that point we're just seeing sort of like a JPEG preview, which these settings do affect, and all these settings do have an impact on JPEGs, but not on RAW except for one category, the gamma. And so once we're loaded in here and we look at them, they all look exactly the same. And this is why I think it's common for people to say, no, picture profiles don't have an effect. Look, every single one of these pictures looks exactly the same. But it's not true for the last three, and those are the only three that we've adjusted the gamma. So just go through these real quick so that you can see what the heck's going on. I'm not cheating here. Every time I read a new one, I'm gonna press to the right. You can even see on the carousel on the bottom that I'm changing. So this first one, picture profile off, creative style set to standard. Picture profile off, creative style set to clear. Picture profile off, creative style set to black and white. So we can now determine that the creative styles have no impact on RAW once they're developed. They all look exactly the same. Now we're gonna switch to picture profile 2, which is the still gamma with everything else reset. Looks exactly the same. So it doesn't matter what picture profile you're on, as long as you're on still gamma, it'll match picture profile off. Black level plus 15, no difference. Go back and forth. No difference if you set the black level up. Then we'll go to the next one, which has a black gamma set to wide and the value set to 0. And then we have black gamma set to wide plus 7. Still no differences. Let's go back 3 or 4. Exactly the same. Now we're going to set the knee to manual with the point at 80% and the slope plus 3. No changes. It looks like there was a shift in the frame there, but the image looks exactly the same. Next one, saturation plus 32. Now you saw in the thumbnail for this one, it was crazy orange and everything, but it looks exactly the same. And now we've got color phase plus 7, and now we have color depth has the red plus 7 and the green minus 7, which obviously should show up here on a red and green Rubik's Cube, but they look exactly the same again. And now detail plus 7. Again, no change. And for the detail one, we can zoom right in. And even if we look at this like crispy edge over here of the sticker, once it renders out, we can see that they look exactly the same. Now we're into color modes. So we've gone through all of the settings inside of picture profile. There's only two remaining, color mode and gamma. So what happens if you change the color mode? Well, if you change the color mode to black and white, doesn't matter, looks exactly the same. You can even change it to really wide one, like S gamma 3, looks exactly the same. So when you choose an S-Log picture profile, it's not the color mode that's making the impact, it's only the gamma, because the color mode still looks exactly the same. And then I also did the movie color mode because it's really, really rich and I thought it would stand out, but they look exactly the same. And now for the last three, it's only the gamma that's changing. So we're still on picture profile 2, we're still using a still gamma up until this point, and everything else is on 0. Now all we're changing is the gamma, but we're leaving the color mode back on still for these three. So this one is Cine 1. It's brighter all of a sudden. We can clearly see a difference. And if we look at the histogram in the top left, that was on still gamma, Cine 1 gamma. It's definitely changed. Now this one's HLG. Looks completely different still. Completely different histogram. Let's go back to Cine 1, still. And the last one, I just chose movie as a gamma. And again, it's different. And they're all different. S-Log's different. The different Cine 1s, you know, there's the ITU. They're all different. If you change the gamma, you will change the RAW. And this can be backed up a little bit by going into the help guide here from Sony. If you look here, they're talking about the picture profiles. And at the, this is the whole help guide for picture profiles, basically. But at the bottom, it says, if you print raw images with shooting settings, the following settings are not reflected. Black level, black gamma, knee, and color depth. But we went further and checked the saturation also doesn't change, the color phase doesn't change, and the detail. Those aren't listed there, but as far as I can tell, they also don't have an impact. But then it says, if you change gamma, the available ISO value range changes. I know what you might be thinking, when I changed the gammas, I was required to change my ISO around. But in order to prove that wrong, I made all these shots at the exact same settings and started at a higher ISO of 2000. So if we go back into Lightroom and we look up here at the exposure settings, we've got ISO 2000 at f2 and 1/100th of a second. And if we look at the different gammas, it's still ISO 2000 all the way across. Because that was a common thing listed on the forums, that the reason why it's changing is because you're not realizing it, but you were at ISO 400, then you went to S-Log and it bumped up to 800. No, these are all shot at ISO 2000 and they didn't shift when I changed the gamma, but the actual curve of the image changed. Let's go back to the help guide. It says, there may be more noise in dark parts depending on the gamma settings. When using S-Log2 gamma, the noise becomes more noticeable. Basically, what this lets us know is that there is a difference based on the gamma. And what I think is going on here is that when the analog to digital conversion, or when the data is being recorded from the sensor based on the charges that it gathered, there's a different gain, there's a different like conversion being applied based on the gamma that's being set in the picture profile. So the actual signal data that's being recorded in the raw file is different depending on the gamma, but all the other stuff isn't. When you increase the saturation, it's not changing how much light is converted into electricity and then how that data is boosted and recorded. That's not changing it. But these gammas are actually changing that, or at least the values are being, a new layer is being put on the values that when these images are being developed from their RAWs, they're looking different. And from a practical standpoint, even if there was an argument to suggest that the RAW photos are all the same regardless of the gamma setting, it doesn't matter because practically they are different no matter how you treat them. And I'll prove this by loading up Capture One as well, just to give an alternate source in case you think it's Lightroom's fault. And I will get rid of these ones so that you don't think I did any funny business. And we'll do a fresh import right from the card. And again, we can see all the thumbnails have all the different aspects to them, but if we import all 18 images, now it's going to do that thing where it normalizes all the images again as it develops the RAWs, the previews disappear, and they all start to look at the same. You can see the saturation one here is going to get turned into a normal looking RAW, and all the way down, and this again is why I think people think that picture profiles don't have an effect. In fact, like I said, I'm to blame for this as well. I also thought they didn't have an effect. And I've even replied to a couple comments saying, don't worry about your picture profile when you're shooting in RAW. And I apologize to those people that I misled, because the gamma will have an impact. Even if it's small sometimes, it will have an impact. So let's just start somewhere in the middle here, and the first batch should all look exactly the same, which they do. And then when we get to the last three, which have the different gammas, we can see that they're different. So it doesn't matter what software you use, changing the gamma changes the way the RAW is developed. And really that's what matters when people say, do the picture profiles have an impact? Yes, your RAW will be developed differently regardless of the software you use if you change the gamma. But you can change any other setting you want, just don't change the gamma if you want to keep them consistent all the way through. But that's going to be it for me. I hope you found this video helpful or at least entertaining. And if you did, make sure you leave it the old thumbs up and consider subscribing if you haven't already. But if you did not find this video helpful or entertaining, feel free to hit the dislike button twice. All right. I'm done.